Welcome to Sharon SDA. Let us treat sin like COVID-19. How is that? Isolating ourselves from it. Ephesians 2:8 and 9 states, "For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." Let us live for Christ.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. It's so good to be with you today. God bless you. I hope your week was not as trying as some, but good nevertheless. And the fact that the Lord has brought us to this place, we know that God has been a good God. We're just happy to have you here at Sharon Seventh-day Adventist Church. We welcome you here. We're still in our virtual mode during this period of pandemic, but nevertheless, we're still praising His holy name. I'm Pastor Michael Dyson, and this is Sharon Seventh-day Adventist Church. We're located in the city of Baltimore, and we are so thrilled to have you with us on this Sabbath as we worship Him and join with others all around the country who are coming together at the 11 o'clock hour on this Sabbath and standing firm and praising the name of the Lord. We have our teleconference number, which we use and we share. This number is important to you because we use it for so many of our contact and outreach with each other. And we want you to be able to contact us as well on that teleconference line. We also use Facebook and we use YouTube. And we thank the Lord for our media team, and we thank Him for our musicians who are able to allow us, even during this time, to still stay connected with one another. We start out each Sabbath morning, each Saturday morning, with our prayer ministry. And our prayer ministry uses that line. You can see it on the screen, 563-999-2090. And then you have to put in the code of 435-402 and hit the pound. And as you come in on that line, as early Sabbath morning at 845, you'll be able to join in with those who are bringing their prayers and prayer requests and petitions and even praise reports together each Sabbath morning. Then that is followed by our Sabbath School Hour. And Sabbath School is a spirited discussion with a Christ-centered lesson. And this quarter, the lesson is dealing with education. And it is really a wonderful lesson and able to allow us to go not only to get our answers from the Word of God, but to discuss it with one another. And again, we use that teleconference number there to join. Sabbath School is awesome time for those who have the quarterly. And even if you don't have one, you can pull it up online. All you have to do is go to SSNET.org, and you can see the Sabbath School lesson, and you can pull it up and be a part of it. And then when you come in and join in the discussion, you'll be right on time. And we're continuing. We started a prayer initiative with our conference, the Allegheny East Conference. This prayer initiative started at the beginning of 2020 and is going strong even now. And every day at 12 noon, Monday through Friday, we come on the line for 30 minutes or more. And it is at that time where we check in with one another. We bring those things that we're praying for. We have names that have asked to be placed permanently on the prayer list. But each day, we want to get those names that we're praying for that day. And we close out the week together in prayer each Friday. Every day, Monday through Friday at 12 noon, only for half an hour. We ask that you join us too. And again, we use that teleconference line of 563-999-2090 and the code of 435-402. Hopefully that you'll enjoy it and join in with us, and I know you'll enjoy it as you come. And then today at 4 p.m., as we do each Sabbath, we have spiritual growth. Got to have some growth, even in the midst of the storm. And so at 4 p.m., utilize again that same number. You can call in. And there is a discussion of those deeper issues that you may have, questions that you want to discuss with one another. And that's at 4 p.m. We have a retired Adventist pastor, Pastor Charles Jenkins, and those that call in have had a blessing by being a part of our spiritual growth. I've got news for you. We're going to try something beginning on next Sabbath, October 24th, everybody. We're going to join in with so many others who are using the technology that's available, and our Sabbath School and our spiritual growth are going to be expanded to be on our Zoom line. So not only will you be able to call in on the teleconference line as normal, but you'll be able to Zoom the Sabbath School, and you know how that is. There are people on there from all over. You'll be able to see each other's faces and still be able to discuss the lesson. And we're going to do that Zoom teleconference beginning next week, not only for Sabbath School, but for our afternoon spiritual growth. It's going to be awesome. That begins next week. We'll give you the code to call in, and it'll be on the website, the Facebook website for the Sharon Church, and we'll announce it for those members on our one call. And if you really are looking to get it, you'll be able to call the church. Contact us either through Facebook or even by a text, and we'll make sure that you have the code, and we'll list it. Now, by the time we get to next Sabbath, they will have already been on that line for Zoom. So you want to get it in advance and be a part of it. It begins on the 24th. And then I am so excited, everybody. Next month, and you need to mark this on your calendar, next month, November 21st, we're going to have a live baptism right here. You ought to say amen. And we're going to do that keeping in mind all of the precautions of safety and protocol that we have to do in this pandemic. But we're going to, right here on this stage, right here on this pool behind me, we're going to baptize. We have some precious souls that have made the decision to follow Jesus every step of the way. If there's ever a time that you want to make your decision and your election sure, now is the time. And so you've got time to plan for it. It is on Sabbath, Saturday, November 21st. It's going to be here during the 11 o'clock hour. You'll hear me announcing more about it as we go forward. I'm excited, and I hope that you are too. We're going to have baptism right here on the 21st of November. I want to thank our elder who closed out our Fundamental Foundations of Salvation Bible Study. We did the first 14 lessons of the set, and those 14 lessons went over many different topics, and the last one was held this week, and my good friend Elder Richard Thomas closed out the whole study with lesson number 14, and we had a topic of his legalism, obedience. He did a great job on it, and I thank him. We're going to come back in the spring. We're going to come back in probably January or February, and we're going to pick up on lesson number 15, and we're going to continue on with that set. There are 27 lessons in the set, and this is what we've completed. It's just the basic of the set, and we're going to go deeper into the Word of God. We hope that you'll continue to be a part of that lesson study as we go forward. Now, we join with everyone. Your vote does count, everybody, and it is your responsibility. We hope that you've registered. We hope that you have taken care of your civic duty and be prepared to vote. Oh, this week is a powerful week, has been a beautiful week. And we have a celebration here at Sharon, a family. We have a couple here who has celebrated 59 years of marriage. 59 years. Hard to imagine, even older than your preacher in some instances, 59 years. And we tie that in with a wonderful celebration for them, and that's Richard and Willa Mae Thomas. They are steadfast, plank-holding members of the Sharon Seventh-day Adventist Church, and we love them dearly. Even now, as Willa Mae is dealing with health issues and the Lord is speaking to her and her family, we just want to join in with them and celebrate. Aren't they a beautiful couple? I feel connected to them. In fact, when Helena and I got to the church here, they were just in the midst of celebrating their anniversary. And right now, this week, they celebrated 59 years of marriage. I feel connected to them, even in a special way. We even had a wedding vow renewal here, and the love was evident in them, even as we came together for that service. It was beautiful. It touched our hearts. And so today, we want to say to them, happy anniversary. God bless you. What God has brought together, let no man put asunder. And we join with them in celebrating 59 years of marital bliss. God bless you so much. We are getting ready for the Lord, everybody. We're getting ready for Jesus. 2020 has been a challenging year. But we know as we get closer to the kingdom that challenges will come. But so is our Lord and Savior coming. And so 2020, we are preparing. We're getting ready. That's why that baptism is coming. There are those that know, I want to be ready to meet the Lord in peace. Happy Sabbath to you. God bless you. Let's worship Him today in spirit and in truth. God bless you.
The world needs to know about this. We set our work aside.
Leave our cares behind.
We leave our cares behind on this day of Sabbath rest.
It's the holy day, a memorial to creation.
On this your holy day,
we come
to give you praise on this day of Sabbath rest.
All right, we need some sharing harmony right here. Come on, everybody.
Sabbath rest.
Sabbath rest, a holy rest. We worship the Lord here in spirit and truth. We want to be connected with this God. And I hope that you, as we come together each week, I hope you have your Bible with you. And if you have your Bible with you, we begin with our affirmation of faith, affirming our faith together. And our affirmation of faith is found in the book of John, chapter 3, verses 16 and 17. You've got the Synoptic Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke. And then there's the fourth gospel in the book of John. John chapter 3, verse 16 and 17. And if you have it, let's read it together. John 3:16 says this: For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And then John 3:17 says this: For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Our blessing. And we continue with our understanding of the gift that God has given us in Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8 and 9. Ephesians 2, 8 and 9. And my Bible says this: For by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Oh, praise the Lord for you and having you here. We are in trying times, everybody. You know it. You sense it all around us. All week long as we're on the prayer line and as we get prayer requests, even away from there, and people will text and say, pray for my sister, pray for my mom, pray for me. That makes special the day that we come together, Sabbath, even more, when we pray together. So let's go in prayer today. I don't know what your request is. I don't know what your petition is. I don't even know if you have an unspoken request. But that's not for me. That's for God. Father in heaven, Lord, we come. We come to this place, and we come to this place of understanding that not by our might nor by our power are we able to even move forward. We thank you for the gift you've given us in Jesus. All of our sins can be brought to the foot of the cross. Father, today we come in just the mode of thanksgiving and celebrating a couple that celebrated 59 years together. And then, Lord, we celebrate with others, even their children who are celebrating 16 years of marriage. We praise God for Richard and Wintry even today. So many others, Lord, are celebrating either their birthday or just celebrating one another. And Father, we come in responding to those requests of people who are dealing with loved ones who today are in need of your healing hand. Father, we ask you to bring families together in love as they are experiencing the transitioning of a loved one. And we're reminded by your word that you've told us that even if sickness is unto death, the dead in Christ will rise first. Father, we ask you to comfort those that are in special need of comforting today. We ask you, Lord, to be with those that are worrying today. We don't know what tomorrow is going to bring, but we know who holds tomorrow. That even in the midst of troubled times and darknesses, the things we've learned about all throughout our lives as Christians, we knew this time would come, and yet here we are in the midst of it. But even in the midst of trouble, we can still see our Savior. Thank you for being our God. Thank you for keeping us and loving us in the midst of all that is going on. Lord, we ask you to forgive us of our sins. We ask you to be with a heart that is wanting to fully commit, Lord, to help them be prepared. And Lord, as the water is being run in a few weeks, that they will say, I want to follow Christ every step of the way. Now, Lord, continue to bless us and keep us. Bless this service today. Bless the speaker of the hour. Allow your anointing to fall on him. We thank you for this day of rest. Bless us now and keep us in the name of the Redeemer. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. We continue our worship in giving, in our tithe and offering. And we thank those who are so willing and understand that we give because God gave first. For God so loved the world that he gave. And we've made ways of you to give here at Sharon. And of course, each week when we come together, we remind you, we have an ability for you to even text in your offering. That's been such a convenient way for so many. And we want to continue to make it so that it is easy for those to give. Anytime, anywhere that you're able to give freely. And we want to thank our deacons for standing by for those who drop off their offerings at the church. What a blessing. Even as we are collecting our offering, we want to pray for our bread ministry. Those that are even today that are having their table out front, giving bread, giving beans, whatever we have to give. We're giving it to those in the community. And Lord, we thank our food pantry and those that are working to feed those that are hungry. We thank you today for being faithful to this God. We thank you for joining us and being with us as we worship him today on this Sabbath day in spirit and in truth. This is the second Sabbath in a row that I've been given a wonderful break. Last Sabbath, we had a powerful message by Elder Douglas Winstead. And today, our local elder, Elder Lyndon Samuels, is going to take charge of the pulpit. And the next voice you hear after the music will be that of our own Elder Lyndon Samuels. God bless you. Happy Your Majesty.
Just want to just say happy Sabbath to everyone. Thanking the Lord first for His great mercies and His loving kindness towards us. Knowing that we are not even worthy. And as the scripture says, that all our righteousness is but filthy rags. So we just thanking the Lord for another Sabbath. He has kept us. He has provided for us. Even our family members and our friends, He has brought yet through another Sabbath. Just want to thank our pastor, Pastor Dyson, for allowing me to share his pulpit. Thank our media personnel, and the rich and the poor son, Kevin. Our first lady is in the house. Our musician. We just want to just thank the Lord for His mercy. Enjoy it forever. Those who are on social media, we pray that God is also blessing us. We pray that you all are keeping safe. Following the laws of the land by wearing our masks and keeping our distance. So happy Sabbath, everyone. As we go into our scripture reading, for this Sabbath will be taken from the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 11 and verse 6. Hebrews 11 and verse 6. But first we're going to jump across to Hebrews chapter 10. Hebrews 10, 37 and 38. And the Bible says that in Hebrews 10, 37, for yet a little while, and he that shall come will come and will not tarry. Verse 38 says, now the just shall live by faith. But if any man draw back, my soul shall have no pleasure in him. Hebrews 11 and verse 6. And the Bible says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Let us pray. Eternal Father and great God, Lord, we just pause to just thank you. We are not thanking you, O God, for what you have done. We are thanking you for who you are. We thank you, O God, for all the blessings you have bestowed upon your children this week. Dear God, you have brought us through another week. We thank you, O God, for the angels you have dispatched that has kept us safe from all harm and danger,
seen and unseen this week. We give you praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Today they Sabbath morning up. Kind of give this sermon because I see what is going on in the world around us. There's so much going on. Even the church, Christian folks, we seem to forget who we serve. So my topic, my sermon today is entitled Unshakable Faith. Unshakable Faith. Looking around, and we see what is going on with the pandemic, COVID-19. And it seems like folks are losing their mind. It seems like we are running low on faith, not trusting in God. Men and women's hearts are failing them. So much confusion, so much problem, chaos, and disaster, hate and crime, problems after problems. Even church folks are weary. Even church folks, and it's hard to say, are running with the crowd, speaking like the crowd. We are acting like the crowd, complaining like the crowd. And it's hard to say we are giving up like the crowd. One songwriter put it this way: and she says that life is easy when you're up on the mountain, when you got peace of mind like you never know, but things change when we're down in the valley. That's when your faith is really put to the test. And believe it or not, some of us are climbing up on the rough side of the mountain. Sickness, disease. Some of us are going through some cancer states, diabetes, stress, loneliness. But this Sabbath morning, saints of God, I'm here to tell you that we are to keep the faith. We are to keep the faith. She goes on to say that the God of the mountain is still God in the valley. And the God of the day is still God in the night. So much going on. even this week on the news, we see this bus driver, this MTA bus driver, working to support his family. Went to work the morning not knowing what is going to happen, what's going to take place in his life. Lost his life. It's sad. You know? And we keep saying, this is our Black Lives Matter. And we're seeing that African-American Black Lives Matter already. A man who was doing his job, shot in cold blood. For what? For what reason? Saints of the Living God, God has called us to live in faith. We are complaining, we are murmuring, we seem to forget whose we are and who we serve. Some of us are forgetting that Jesus said, "Come unto me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Christian folks seem to be forgetting that God is. In the book of Isaiah chapter 41, the Bible says, "I, the Lord, have called thee in righteousness and will hold thy hand." We keep forgetting that the scripture says,
"Fear not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee." In the same book, Isaiah chapter 43, verses 2 and 3. And the Bible says, "When thou pass through the water, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned." We keep forgetting. O ye of little faith. Jesus, sometimes that was Jesus, sometimes he said, "O ye of little faith."
I was looking at the story with the woman with the issue of blood. And this woman did everything in her way, everything possible to be healed. She went to doctors. And this is an individual who couldn't walk the streets. She would be scorned by others because of the issue of blood. And she said, "If I could just touch the hem of his garment, and through the crowd," she wiggled her way through the crowd, "and just get a little touch on Jesus' garment." That's the kind of power that the God we serve has. Even his garments. And Jesus said, who touched me? Hundreds of people gathered, and the disciples said, Master, so much folks, you asking who touched you? And Jesus saw her, and he said to her, daughter, your faith has made you whole. Where is our faith as children of the living God? It's sad to say that some of us need to go to the great physician, Dr. Jesus, because it seems like some of us suffers from spiritual amnesia. Tend to question God. Tend to murmur. We tend to complain. God is calling men and women in these last days to keep the faith. God is calling men and women in these last and dreadful days to keep the faith. When God puts a promise in our hearts, we believe it's going to happen so strongly that nothing can talk us out of God's promises. All our circumstances, all our problems, all our concern, God's got this. God is still the same God. Yesterday, today, and forever. He's the same God Abraham served. He's the same God of Isaac and the same God of Jacob. Where is your faith? God is still on his throne. He is bigger than any obstacle. He already has his way. And at the exact time, what he promised will come to pass. Oh, ye of little faith. Thank God that the answer is on the way. Instead of talking about how big our problem is, let us talk about how big our God is. He is bigger than any problem. Bigger than any problem we face, saints. God is calling men and women in these last days to keep the faith. The problem is with some of us, we don't want to go through anything.
We don't want to go through no situation. We always want our life to be nice and peachy. I got some news for us. It ain't gonna happen. We always want to act like God is unfair. We don't want to go through no problems. When tribulation comes, we want to quit on God. We complain, don't even want to put up a little fight. Don't even want to put up a little fight. Be so quick to just throw in the towel. Yes, we go through stuff. Yes, we have our problems. Yes, we have concerns. But we got to fight, saints of God. Stop sitting around and complaining. And as the songwriter says, stand up and fight anyhow. You know, back in the Caribbean, when we go home and there are times we get in fights in school or on the block, and we go home and sometimes we might be crying, and when your parents ask you what happened, and you go crying and weeping and say, so and so hit me. And your parents will turn to you and say, next time, fight. So this Sabbath morning, we had a fight. This is a battle, saints of God. This thing is real. The enemy wants to sift us like wheat. That's why the Apostle Paul says to us that we are to
put on the whole armor of God, that we may be able to stand in that evil day. Ephesians 6:11. Put on the whole armor of God. God is calling for fighters, not quitters. God is calling for backbone Christians,
not jellyback Christians. I wonder, I want to soak a little bit. God is calling for some Abrahams who obey his voice. God is calling for some Daniel in the lion's den. He is calling for some Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. God is calling for some Joseph this morning. God is looking for some Paul. He is calling on you and I. He's even calling for some Esthers this morning. We are to stand like the brave. Are we a bunch of weaklings? God is not calling no weaky, mamby-pamby Christian men
and women. God is just looking for a few good men who will fight the good fight of faith. Are you and I ready to fight that good fight of faith? Are we ready to fight the good fight of faith? We tend to underestimate the enemy and his job, as the scripture says, is to seek, kill, and destroy. We are dealing with a persistent adversary. There is no time off with the devil, saints of God. There is no sick leaves with the devil, no vacation trip.
He is working overtime. And the same how he studies you, it is the same how we are to study his tactics. Because he's going to, we tend to just act like, you know, we could play around with Satan. This is a being that God left him with all his powers. And he is way stronger than you and I. Don't think you could stand up on your own. Just ask our four parents. They will tell you. He knows our every weakness. And don't think for 1 minute, saints of God, that the enemy is playing around. Because he is not. In the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 4, and verse 7, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7, and the Bible says, the Apostle Paul makes it plain. He says, I fought the good fight. I have finished the race. And here it is right here. He said, I've kept the faith. Faith, unshakable faith. Paul went through hell. The Apostle Paul went through hell. But he kept the faith. What are we doing in these last and trying days? When trials come, because they're going to come. Trials going to come and tribulations is going to come. Look around, saints of God. Folks are dying without faith. Folks are dying without hope. Are we trusting in God? Are we trusting in his promises? Are we just sitting around and hoping that things going to be all right? Scripture says that we have to trust in God. Lean not unto our own understanding. It comes a time, saints of God, when we have to get rid of our Bibles. They're going to lock down our churches. What you going to do? What you and I going to do? Are we keeping the faith? Are we rooted and grounded in the scripture? Because the last time I read my Bible, the Bible says that faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
fighting that good old fight of faith. Every little thing we complain. I don't know what you're going through. So much is going on. This morning, saints of God, I'm here to tell you.
Let us keep the faith. God called us. Jesus said in his word that the world hated me and the world gonna hate you. Don't think that this Christian journey is a walk in the park. Stuff is gonna happen, saints. Trials and tribulation. What will happen when the time comes when we are put into prison? What will happen when the time comes when we have to defend our faith? Faith, unshakable faith. This well-known and often quoted passage is quite significant in that this epistle was Paul's last before martyrdom. It's significant
for believers today because it serves as a stark reminder that the Christian life is a struggle against evil. We're going to go through some tough times until Jesus comes. Faith, unshakable faith, saints of God. Are we ready to?
Are we sure we're ready to fight? Elder Fortson, are you ready to fight the good fight of faith? Brother Kevin, are you ready to fight that good fight of faith? Pastor Dyson, are you ready to fight that good fight of faith? Elders and deacons, musicians, are we ready to fight that good fight of faith? We are soldiers in the army of the Lord.
Are we the Triple C Christians? So what is the Triple C Christian, preacher? Brother Mosley? Let me break it down. Let me just break it down. The Triple C Christians. Cotton candy Christians. Let me say it again. Cotton candy Christians. The Triple C Christians. have mercy. The scripture says, you know, we are to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, but the scripture doesn't say we are to sit around and do nothing. In my 50 plus years on this planet, I have never seen any army that goes into battle without armor. Faith, unshakable faith. We ought to learn the art of war against the enemy. He studied you and he knows you better than you know yourself. He knows us, saints of God.
It's just a simple message, saints. Unshakable faith. It's simple. And the devil study us. Think he gonna give you a, think he gonna give us any rest? He is not gonna rest. Satan is not gonna rest. Stop complaining. You lose your job, unshakable faith. Them wayward kids we praying for and won't come back to the Lord, unshakable faith.
Good friends walk away, unshakable faith. You got some news from the doctor? And it's not the news you wanted to hear, unshakable faith. You lost your job? On your bed of affliction, saints of God, unshakable faith. We serve a God who is able, unshakable faith. Here we are playing around with the enemy. Knows our every weakness. He knows what button to push to take us off. We got to fight. We got to fight, saints of God. We got to hold up that blood-stained banner. We have to hold it up until we die. Faith, unshakable faith. God is looking for some mighty men and women of valor, saints of God. They have to fight.
Faith, unshakable faith. Where would we go? Where will we hide? But one thing I could remind us that God said the battle is his. Got to hold up that blood-stained banner.
Jesus died for you and me on that cross of Calvary, that wicked cross. He went through stuff. Christ went through hell. We're going to go through some stuff, but keep the faith. Back to the scripture, Paul say, I fought the good fight, I finished the race, I kept the faith.
Faith, unshakable faith. God is looking for some valiant men and women who will look the devil in his eyes and ask him, is that all you have? Is that all you got, Satan? That defeated foe, he was defeated when Christ was on that cross. When Jesus said, it is finished, Satan was defeated. Even before that, even in the garden, but God is just looking for some men and women, saints of God, to hold on, to fight that good fight of faith. Strong men and women, no weakling. I said it before that no coward could be a Christian. To be a Christian, you had to have backbone. I'm going to take you some verses of scripture.
Second Samuel, chapter 23. And these are mighty men.
As the Bible puts it, mighty men who serve with King David. Second Samuel, chapter 23. And I'm going to start at verse 8. And the Bible says that these be the names of the mighty men whom David had. The mighty men of whom David had. The Tachmonite that sat in the seat, chief among the captains. The same was Adino, the Eznite. He lift up his spear against 800 whom he slew at one time. One battle. 800 men. My. And after him was Eleazar, the son of Dodo, the Ahohite, one of three mighty men. Here it is again. Mighty men. God is looking for some mighty men and women in these last days. No weaky, frail Christian gonna make it in God's kingdom. One of three mighty men with David, when they defiled the Philistine that were there gathered together to battle, and the men of Israel were gone away. This runaway Christians. Kind of remind me of back in the days when you and your crew, your friends, and we going in and trouble start, and They run and they leave you behind. You alone. This man, stand up. And the Bible says in verse 10, he arose and smote the Philistines until his hand was weary and his sword clave on his hand clave onto the sword that day. That is battle. Wow. My. The man fight till his hand stuck to his sword. Could you imagine? And the Lord wrought a great victory that day. And the people returned after him only to the spoil. Here, these cowards come running back. Yeah, I said it. In chapter, verse 11, and after him was Shema, the son of Agi, the Hararite. And the Philistines were gathered together into a troop. Where was a piece of ground full of lentils? And the people fled from the Philistines. Here we go again. As a little problem happens in our lives, we cramp, we crumble, we go into some corner complaining to God. Why me? Why am I going through this? Lord, I return my tithes and off faithfully. I'm in Wednesday night prayer meeting all the time. Why? Why have you allowed my kids to stray? They grew up in the church, Lord. Why? And we complain and we murmur. And the people fled from the Philistines. But he stood, listen to this, but he stood in the midst of the ground and defended it and slew the Philistine. And the Lord wrought a great victory. Simple, simple message. Unshakable faith. This is who God is calling in these last days. Mighty, mighty men. Men who will stand their ground. Are we standing our ground? First Lady, as the songwriter said, stand up
for Jesus. Are we standing up and standing up for Jesus? Are we allowing our situation to take us away from the glory of God? God is looking for a few good men, a few mighty men. We gotta be tough. We gotta
be tough. This ain't no time to be playing around, saints of God. This ain't no time to be, fun time is over. It's either you're in or you're out. It's either we in or we are out. The songwriter said, I've tried to be a Christian, living a worldly life. And he goes on to say, you can't have one foot in. You got to be right with God. As our dear pastor always says, you got to be all in. Faith, unshakable faith. Going to do one more scripture.
When we are finished, just one more scripture, and we are going to go home. Isaiah chapter 40, Isaiah 40 and chapter, and we'll start from chapter 20, from verse 27, sorry, Isaiah the 40th chapter.
From verse 27, the Bible say, why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speak it, O Israel? My way is hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my God. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainted not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. And here it is right here. Verse 29, he giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increased strength. But they that wait upon the Lord, verse 31, shall renew their strength. And they shall mount up on wings like eagle. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. Faith, unshakable faith. It's right there in scriptures. The Bible says that the just shall live by faith. So in closing, just want to say that there are times
your faith going to waver. We imperfect. There are times our faith will waver. Because some of the great men in the Bible, their faith had wavered. Elijah, and Samson, and the list had to go on and on and on. But saints of the living God, let us remember that we serve a God who is able, a God who loves us and cares for us. God who will not give us more than we can bear. So happy Sabbath, everyone. I pray the blessings of the Lord upon each and everyone. And let us remember, saints, please stay safe and obey the laws of the land. So praise the Lord, everyone, and happy Sabbath. And as I finish and as I close out, I say, Lord, thank you again for another Sabbath day. And as the old elder would say, one Sabbath closer to the coming of our Lord and Savior. Let us be ready. Let us prepare ourselves, oh God, with faith. Unshakable faith. We give you praise, honor, and glory, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, and amen. Happy Sabbath.
Devotion for only you. I believe that God is listening. And I believe that God hears every sincere sinner's prayer. And just as he says in his word that he takes care of the little birds, he asks us the question, how much more will I do for you? I can hear him saying this. I got my eyes on you. Can you hear him? He says, I got my eyes on you. I got my eyes on you. Cause I'm so in love with you. He's got his eyes on me too. Thank you, Lord. He's got his eyes on me too. He's got his eyes on me too. And he tells me, cause I'm so in love with you. Thank you, Lord. Give me doves eyes. Give me undistracted devotion for only you. Thank you, Lord. I love you, Lord.